the government in order to have my rights optimally protected. The other group says, no, I prefer not to have any government. I don't want to follow any law. I don't believe in. That's the anarchist position. Not just taxes, any law. So I don't want to, it could be the law on abortion or the law on statutory rape or pedophilia, whatever it is. I have my own position, and I'm not going to be forced to follow any law that a government tells me I have to follow. Each law, I reserve the right to decide whether I want to follow it or not follow it. And that's the anarchist position, and I think they should have a right to try their experiment. And I'm surprised not so many are interested.
I would agree. I'm kind of surprised as well, but... how does the government get its power?
Proper legitimate governmental power is derived from consent of the people. And that's what happened with in the Constitutional Convention. The representatives of the people got together, and as Benjamin Franklin is famous for saying, when asked what they did there, he said, well, we've gotten you a republic. Let's see if you can keep it. Which what he meant was a limited government. And as you know, initially the government started very small, but it has expanded into roles which it should not be in, namely individual issues like, you know, whether you want to take drugs or not, or whether prostitution should be legal or not, or gambling, or all these things, which have nothing to do with protecting anybody's rights. And worse, taking money from some groups and giving it to others, which is redistribution of wealth, and a large part of our federal budget is dedicated to that. So if we had a limited government, our government would be a lot smaller, but it would be a lot smaller based on principle. It's not about more or less government. It's about what principle you use to decide what is the proper size of the government. And so I think that the people should only be able to decide democratically within the limited sphere of what is the proper function of government. Outside of that sphere, it's irrelevant how many people think one thing or another. That shouldn't be it's not a proper function of the government.
But where would you say that this power is coming from, though? How does government get this power?
From consent of the people. All legitimate governmental power comes from the people. It's consent. So that's how you get a moral government. Now, Mao Zedong thought from the barrel of a gun, and, you know, some monarchists thought that they derived their power from God, etc. But I don't think any of those are legitimate.
So, if the government gets its power from the people, I mean, if government is... You're saying that, you know, government is the only thing they should be able to do is to protect citizens, and that's the only role.
Protect their individual rights, their right to their life, their liberty and their property, or as the Declaration of Independence says, to their pursuit of happiness. That's Jefferson's own. And it was a good thing he put that in, because that links the function of a government and having it protect their rights to what should be your ultimate value, which is that people should be able to and should pursue their individual happiness.
But to be able to do this, government has to be funded to do this somehow. I mean, where are they going to get that funding? How are they going to get that funding?
Right. And they are funded by taxes. And I'm saying that taxes are legitimate as long as they are used for proper functions. As long as they're not used to abridge people's rights, personal rights, like I discussed before, or as long as they're not used for redistribution of wealth, they're only used for protecting us from foreign tyrants. Like, that's why we have an army, to protect us from criminals. That's why we have police, to resolve the disputes so people don't resolve their disputes through force. So that's why we have a judiciary. That's it. That's all we need. So we need just a limited government. And that's what people, when our country was founded, believed. And they got that basically from John Locke, who wrote a book called The Rights of Man. And the founding fathers were persuaded by that logic, and that's why they told King George to go fuck himself.
Yeah. but still, you're saying that these are the legitimate functions of government that have to be...